police cars and a crime scene. It was the last thing Dee Jakubowski expected the night she went to check on her East Tulsa flower shop at 1 in the morning.
I got a call that my alarm was going off. So I got dressed and went back to the shop, and it was a balloon had gotten loose and was drifting.
She ran in without turning on the lights in the front and then went back to the store's office when she heard the door open. A moment that would forever change her life.
Just as I got to the door, he grabbed me. He was saying, "Where's the money? Give me the money." And I'm going, "There isn't any money. It's gone for the night." And in the process, he assaulted me and left.
Dee didn't know her attacker, and she's not alone. Thousands of women are victims of crime in Tulsa every year. 9 years ago, as part of a 2 News investigation, we took in 2003 crime data from Tulsa police. We then mapped out the areas of Tulsa that saw the highest number of violent crimes against women. Crimes including rape, murder, assault, and robbery. At that time, we found high crime areas to be in and around Swan Lake, downtown, and the area at I-244 in Yale. We wanted to know if those numbers would be different all these years later. So we again asked police for the data, this time mapping out crimes involving women in Tulsa for 2011. We found the same areas, again showing the highest number of crimes against women, Swan Lake, downtown, and I-244 in Yale.
I don't know why those numbers would be like that. You know, I'm trying to think of those places you describe. Are there higher concentration of apartment complexes, residential? It's really hard to say, to put my finger on why those areas would be more higher for females being victims.
That's the proof that it happens to everyone or anyone.
That's why both Dee and police say it's important to always be aware of your surroundings.
Especially in the summertime. More people are out. More chances of people being victims. Whether you're using the river trail to run or walk, or you're just going in your neighborhood to walk around your block.
As for Dee, her attacker was caught and ended up behind bars. Since that horrifying day, Dee's vowed to help other victims of crime. She's in a volunteer group for Divis Call Rape, where she can help victims go through the process of recovery. She's also been instrumental at the state capitol, getting 3 laws passed that help rape victims. Despite what she went through that night in the flower shop 14 years ago, Dee calls herself the luckiest woman.
Everybody wants to leave the world better, and I got to leave the world better and be alive to see it.
You can see where crimes have occurred in your neighborhood, even on your street. We have an interactive map on our website. Just head over to KGRH.com. In Tulsa, Marla Carter, 2 News works for you.